Oh, welcome back to the Steve Robb Show. Today we're doing construction. Well, not really. Okay, guys. First off, I don't know if anybody would be interested in watching me do a build of an outhouse. I mean, I can't see too many of you guys interested in wanting to know how to build an outhouse. But I'm pretty sure I'm building an outhouse this summer for my camp. The one that I originally put in there, I built like in about 4 or 5 hours in the driveway just to fire it up there, just to have something to use. And you can see the other outhouse I have is quite elaborate, and the new one I'm going to build is not going to be as much because it costs too much money. But I want to talk a little bit about construction because a friend of mine wants to learn how to do some of this stuff as well. And he started asking me some strange questions, and I thought I'd go over some of the answers to some of the I thought was strange questions. But first of all, it was about this. When you've got, there you go right there, you know, some 2x4s and that kind of stuff, and you know, this is pressure treated wood, and you want to fire in, you know, what he thought he should have used, screws. And guys, I'm saying never use deck screws. They're garbage. They're just crap. And you're probably saying to yourself, okay, like, what are you talking about? Okay. Let's start off here. These are the deck screws right here. You know, you can see them. You buy them at Home Depot and you can buy them anywhere. And I buy them by the case, guys, like a big case. I don't know how much is in there. Maybe I'm thinking like 2,000, 2,500 at a time. So I do use them. I do use them and I like them. But this is the catch, guys. And I'm going to get that in a minute. And this is the standard across the industry, using galvanized nails. Now, if you're going into pressure treated wood, I recommend the hot dip galvanized nail. And this is my choice of weapon. And I like using the nail gun. And this is my nail gun here. It's a pass load. Fantastic piece of equipment. It uses a combustible, I think it's a butane cylinder, and an electric rechargeable battery. And it fires them in, and you just load them in here, you know. And there was some in there. And that's it. So, yeah, so these ones here, you can't use them in pressure treated wood. And this little box here I'm going to show you was $72 when I can buy a whole case three times the size for around $40. And the reason being is, if you take a look here, if I can get this in the shot here, you see where it says the ACQ, I think it is. If you're going to use these in pressure treated wood, they're fine. But if you just use the regular that are not galvanized, they're no good. Not in pressure treated wood, because I've seen a deck about maybe, has to be like a 15-year-old deck, and The nails that they used in the nail gun were not compatible. Now, I don't know about the new pressure treated wood. Now, the new pressure treated wood seems to be all like brown looking lumber, but it just rotted out the old nails. So, what I'm getting here is I'm going to show you the reason why you never use deck screws for structural. Now, if you have like a deck board, and like I do all the time, the only time I ever use this is to drive in 5/4 boards or 1.5-inch boards, that kind of stuff. You know, just, you know, driving them straight down. And that's it. But I never use them, you know, to use anything that has to do with any kind of structural support. And this is where a friend of mine's question was. He wants to build one of these outhouses. And he thought he would just use, you know, build everything out of the deck screws. And I told him, no, you can't do that because the deck screws are crap. And they're made just for going on the top, as far as I'm concerned. You can do whatever you want and have lots of luck with that. But I'm going to show you why you should never do it. And, I mean, it's for an outhouse. Okay, you could probably get away with all kinds of stuff. I mean, it's only for an outhouse, right? But to me, I just won't use them. And I'll show you why. Let me get set up and I'll get back to you. Okay, guys, I got the got my regular nail here, and I've got you know, the deck screw and the vise here, and I'm just going to show you the reason why you should never use a deck screw for any type of structural support. And of course, I know there's lots of fellas on my channel that are contractors, and they all know this, but there's a lot of people that I guess don't know it, including my friend, that suggested that he would just go pick up a box of deck screws, and away we go. But I just want to show you something. I got my hammer here, and I'm just going to hit the end here with the hammer, and you watch this, guys. There, sheared right off like nothing. And here's the, I mean, you can pound a nail right down flush like that, and it's not going to break. But the deck screw, total fail. Okay, guys, I hope you found that interesting. And by the way, I'm going to show you this thing in action, you know, in the summertime when I'm using it. And maybe you guys have never used one of these before. And I prefer this to the air-operated ones. And that's pretty well it, guys. I hope you like this little bit of a tip from Steve Robb. So there you go. Come back again, guys. Let's have some fun. Bye now.